Hi everyone, my name is Danielle. I am a project coordinator with Parks Canada's Atlantic Salmon Conservation and Restoration Project. I am here in Gros Morne National Park. Come join us on some monitoring work today. Gros Morne is one of the five national parks that are working together to recover Atlantic salmon. The other national parks are Fundy, Kouchibouguac, Cape Breton Highlands, and Terra Nova. Salmon populations at these different sites are all at various stages. Some are healthy, but others are threatened or endangered. And our aim is to study these populations and figure out exactly when we should be stepping in on our recovery actions. Is it effective to come in once a population is already endangered, or should we be stepping in before, when populations are still healthy? So right now I am going to put on a dry suit, which is basically similar to a wetsuit, but you stay dry underneath so you can wear all of your clothing and you zip it up and then you're watertight. All right, we're gonna start our snorkel survey. And you'll notice behind me, we have three people in the water and one person here on shore behind me. And it's important to have a shore support to count all the salmon that we see in the water, as well as to provide safety support. So the team is saying they're ready to start. Everyone's good. They're starting their survey all in a line. This is to make sure that they're covering the entire area that we're monitoring. Sean's putting up his hand and that means he's seeing salmon. They're communicating to Todd and Todd's writing all of these numbers down and he's writing down the location that we're seeing these fish. Snorkel surveys help biologists track the number of salmon returning to the rivers each year. We can then look at these numbers regionally to see the peaks and the valleys of salmon abundance and how they relate to our recovery efforts. So we've reached the end of our snorkel survey and we have met up with the team doing biofilm sampling. So let's go check it out. Kurt?
Yes?
What are we doing here?
So we are collecting biofilm from a number of rocks in the river to get an idea or an estimate of how productive these rivers are. So this biofilm covers rocks. It's that slippery stuff that everyone falls on when you're walking through a river. And so we want to collect that. We're going to scrape it off with this toothbrush. As you can see, the water's getting greener. And then from there, we can measure how green, how much stuff is in there.
Very cool. And why do we care about biofilm being in our rivers?
Right, so biofilm is really important because it's the base of the food web. And it feeds the little organisms like these guys right here. These little, we call them macroinvertebrates. They're the river bugs. These are important because this is what salmon eat primarily when they're juveniles in the river. And so the more biofilm there is, more algae, the more food at the bottom of the food web, there's more food for these bugs. That means there's more bugs for salmon to eat and we can sustain larger, healthier salmon populations.
All right, I'm out of my dry suit and the day is done. Check out this awesome view behind me. Now it's just time to pack up and head on out. Thank you so much for joining me on this adventure today. Bye-bye.